Today we are assembling a curved corner Winemaker series rack. We have the front spacer bars, the back spacer bars, the stackable beam supports, the front and the back, and then the trim pieces that go on the top and the bottom. Each wine rack comes with an anchoring kit. An anchoring kit is what you need to attach the rack to the wall, which is an important step. As this rack is a display rack, we also have the display bottle trays, which show off one bottle in each row. Finally, we have the 8 racks. You'll be given 4 lefts and 4 rights. All these items are needed to assemble this rack along with a nail gun. Alternatively, you can choose to use a hammer, or you can take the time to pre-drill holes and screw them together. Take a look at the assembly guide as you view this video. The handy guide will show you where to put the spacer bars on the front and the back, and how to attach it to the wall. We have our installation manager, Joe, showing us how to assemble this rack. He has his nail gun and compressor and is ready to go. The first thing he prefers to do is to put the back spacer bars on. He'll take the top spacer bar and fit it into the rack. He uses an 1.5-inch brad nail. He recommends you double shoot, meaning put 2 nails into each notch in the back. He prefers only a single shoot into the front bars. So work your way around all those rails and make sure they fit nice and tight into the spacer bar. Work your way down to the next spacer bar, which goes a row below the display row. As the placement is slightly different on a 3-foot versus 4-foot curved corners, the assembly manual will be a valuable tool. As you work your way down the rack, adding additional spacer bars, it's easier to fit the spacer bars going in from top to bottom as you're nailing all the rails in. As you can see, Joe has been nailing the sides in first and then moving inward. This will ensure a tighter fit. After those back spacer bars are finished, you move on to the front spacer bar. Continue to use the 1.5-inch brad nails and shoot 1 nail into each rail. For the 3 middle sections where the 2 racks meet, make sure they line up. Joe puts his finger behind to ensure there's a 3/16-inch gap or so. You don't want it too tight together, you just want it to fit and support all the rails. You'll see him adjusting each one to make sure that fits correct. Continue to put a nail into each railing of the entire rack. Here's a tip for you. On each of these spacer bars, one side has a double staple, while the other side has 1 staple. So look at them carefully. Joe prefers to make sure the double staple is on the bottom to hide it. We're going to watch Joe finish adding on that spacer bar, which will conclude the front of the wine rack, and then we'll move on to the top. Here we have the stackable beam supports that go on front and back to support additional racks. Double shoot 2 nails to each side of the beam support onto each railing. Once this rack is finished, you can stack the next curved corner on top so your racks can go from floor to ceiling. The back beam support does exactly the same thing. Add that on, and once you have the corner set in, before you do the interior rails, be sure to shoot down into the rail from the stackable beam support and keep your gap the same way it is all the way down. You want that 3/16 gap so the entire thing is supported. Then you nail on your trim pieces that are nailed on below the stackable beam support. You have that small 5/8 gap from the stackable beam support and the trim. It goes on right below it. In this curved corner, the reveal rail or display row holds the wine bottle, a 15-degree display, which is always a bestseller as people love to show off their wines and also locate specific brands of wine bottles. Those display trays hook onto the back railing. Once you insert them, you turn it around and take a 1-inch nail and tack into the rail to hold it. And after that, your display rows will be extremely secure. And that completes the curved corner with the display rows. I'll add in a little bit of talking in between here to talk about things and finish it off and probably speed up some of the things. Yay, that's done.